Water is a compound that is made up of chemical elements, and it has the most recognizable chemical formula in the world, H2O. And by breaking down this formula, we know that there are two hydrogen atoms, along with one oxygen atom, that make up the building blocks of a water molecule. And the amount of water molecules in just 1 liter of water is astonishing. If we imagine that a grain of sand represents one water molecule, we would need a cubic volume 200 kilometers long, 200 kilometers wide, and 200 kilometers high, full of sand to represent the molecules. The hydrogen atom is the simplest and most fundamental atom of them all, consisting of a single proton and a single electron. It is the most common element in the universe, making up roughly 75% of all visible matter. Oxygen is the second most abundant element on Earth, and the third most common in the universe, after hydrogen and helium. The oxygen atom is 16 times heavier, and roughly 13% larger than the hydrogen atom. It has 8 electrons, 2 in the first shell, and 6 in the second shell. Hydrogen was created almost immediately after the Big Bang, making it the first element in the universe. As the temperature dropped enough in the aftermath of the explosion, protons and neutrons started combining to form the nuclei of elements such as hydrogen, helium, and traces of deuterium and lithium. Oxygen, however, was created within high-energy conditions inside stars much bigger than the Sun, which they released into space through supernova explosions when they reached the end of their life cycles. This process started hundreds of millions of years after the Big Bang. The two elements were now abundant enough in the universe to start reacting with each other, to create the single most important molecule for life on our planet, the water molecule. You have probably seen H2O drawn similar to this, but to understand its properties, we must look closer at how the electrons are shared between the atoms. The distinctive V-shape can be explained by the principles of bent molecular geometry. This theory states that the physical structure of molecules directly influence their properties and behaviors. Electron pairs surrounding an atom repel each other and will therefore arrange themselves to be as far apart as possible. In the case of a water molecule, the oxygen atom has two pairs of electrons that are not shared with the hydrogen atoms, also known as lone pairs. Because the repulsion from these lone pairs is greater than the repulsion from the shared electron pairs, the result is a bent molecular structure. The oxygen atom also shares one electron with each of the hydrogen atoms in order to create a more stable molecule. This sharing of electrons between the atoms creates a strong bond, which is also known as a covalent bond. It is important to remember that these strong electromagnetic bonds are restless vibratory entities and not solid tubes. The electrons are not stationary, but exist in quantum mechanical orbitals, or electron clouds, that are shared between the two atoms. However, these electrons are not shared equally. Because the oxygen atom is more electronegative, it pulls the electrons slightly closer to itself. This results in a slight negative charge near the oxygen, while the hydrogen side carries a slight positive charge. Because of these opposite charges, H2O becomes a polar molecule. And because it's a polar molecule, it now attracts other water molecules that are also polar. These oppositely charged atoms now form bonds that are called hydrogen bonds, with up to 4 other different water molecules. The hydrogen bond is not as strong as the covalent bond, but provides the key to understanding water's behavior and characteristics, explaining many of its unique and essential properties that are vital for life and natural processes on Earth. In the episodes to come, we shall unravel the mysteries of these remarkable hydrogen bonds and the amazing properties of the water molecule. So join us, as in the next chapter, we'll witness how these invisible forces weave a delicate yet robust film at the water's surface, allowing certain insects to walk on water, and why droplets of water have a tendency to sculpt themselves into spherical shapes with elegant precision.